Our job is to do oversight and make sure they're doing their job. So how do we make it happen?
The two most important steps are first to reduce the number of select agent laboratories. The number of select agent personnel, the volume of select agent research increased by a factor of 20 to 40 over the last decade.
Why has there been such a great expansion?
So it was in large measure, essentially in whole, a response to the 2001 anthrax mailings. At the time of the 2001 anthrax mailings, it was understandable because it was expected here and elsewhere that the U.S. was under attack with a biological weapon from a foreign source. It was expected that biology would be put on a mobilization footing to address this threat. We expanded by a factor of 20 to 40. Now, more than a decade later, more than a decade after, it has become absolutely clear that the 2001 anthrax mailings did not come from a foreign source, and after it has become clear that the investigation believes it came from within the U.S. biodefense establishment, we have the strange situation that we have expanded that establishment by a factor of 20 to 40 without reason and without reassessment.
And the risks are self-evident? Is that
the risks follow mathematically. When you increase the number of personnel by a factor of 20 to 40, particularly when you recruit people without prior experience, new to the field, you increase risks, and you increase those risks by a factor of 20 to 40 or more.